renewal comes by committing to that one for which you are called for. For that one for which God allows many things happen in your life. The other day I was talking to our brothers. I was telling them a story. A king, he won so many nations, and then he was tensed whether the enemies may come. What will happen? Will the generals be faithful to him? He was upset and coming. And then on the way he saw under the tree one man sitting and laughing, cracking jokes. He got shock of his life. He went to him and said, "I have conquered many nations. I am not happy. Why are you happy? How are you happy? Sitting under the tree with your komana, with a little clothes. You are so happy. What is this?" That man said, "Hello, king, you have conquered the nations, but I have conquered myself. Many needs will come in our lives. We should learn to conquer ourselves. That's why in Hosea 4:6 says, my children are perishing due to lack of knowledge. That's why in Romans 12:2 the word of God says, allow God to renew your mind by choosing what is pleasing to God, what is acceptable to God. Many things will come on our way. Today the topic given to me was the renewal of your mind. So the mind has to renew, means the mind has to focus first to oneself. What do I want with my life? With one life, what do I want? If you read the book of Revelation chapter 3, verse 3 onwards, hello my dear, you think that you are living, but really you are dying. Take care, even the little what you have, you don't lose it. The book wants it. You think you are living, no, you are dying. Take care, even the little what you have of the Lord is not lost. Don't throw yourself for anything and everything. Don't hold on to glittering paper and throw away. It's because of chocolate. Don't throw yourself into all kinds of things. We should know what is important. The king looked at him and said, "You have conquered yourself." "Yes, man. I have conquered so many nations. I'm disturbed, man. I have no sleep. I have no rest. I don't trust people. I don't know what will happen to me next." Then the man said, "You go up. There is a church. There is one more man is there. He is greater than me." So he went up and saw another man is rejoicing in the temple, in the church, thanking the Lord. "I will sing of the mercies of the Lord forever. I will sing." This fellow is also having nothing, but he is so happy. He is dancing, praising God. What is this? He went to him, stopped him. "I am the king of this place. Good morning, king. Please sit. Come on, let's worship the Lord." He is going on. "I am the king. I have come." "Yes, king, what can I do for you? Can I do something for you?" He sat under the feet of the king. "No, no, no, no. Sit up. Where did he get this joy? I went to that fellow who down. He said, king, you have conquered the nations, but I have conquered myself." And that man said, "Yes, conquering self, knowing self, understanding what the self wants, is the first stage of renewal of the mind. And the second stage is to know the heaven. You should know yourself. You should know Him, your God. What He wants from you. Why did He create you? Why He allows these things in your life? You should know His purpose, His planning. Why did He choose you? Why did He place you? What do you want? What does He want from you? Choose Him and your mind will be peaceful. Many things will come on our way. Today, man doesn't understand what is eternal. And so, he throws away his life for all that is unwanted elements. Are less important becomes more important at the cost of more important ones. That's why in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 18 he said, today's man's main problem is not able to take decisions to choose that which is eternal at the cost of that which is passing away. Rather, he holds on that which is passing away and throws away that which is eternal. That's why 2 Corinthians 4:18 says, that which is eternal has to rise above that which is passing away. We can do many things, but we have to choose. That's why in the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 3 verse 13, it is written, on that day when we stand before God, all our actions will be burnt, and that which we have lived for God alone will stand. The rest all will become ashes in front of the Lord. That day people will be crying, oh, God gave me opportunity to do this. God spoke to me this, but I rejected it. And today, I have ended up in misery of my life. Because the enemy is mad after to take away the light God has given to us. To make our body a defiled body. The enemy is mad after to defile us and to tie us up, whereby we don't reach the shore. A man was told by his wife, your daddy is so sick. Please go and buy the medicine and come back fast. There is no other way except one boat. So he went, and the boat people will be there. You have to pay a little money. They will take you from this place to other place. He went to there, and on the way he saw the arak shop. He felt a feel like a drinking. He said, no, my daddy is sick. He went nearby. And the smell came. The smell pulled him. And he just peeped inside. And there some people are drinking. And nearby chicken pieces they were enjoying. He forgot. He went inside. Sat and drank. By the time he realized, it was getting dark. Hooray, my father is sick. He's crying like a child, runs and buys the medicine. Became very late. He was drunk, not able to walk, not able to run. He's afraid if he runs, the bottle may be broken. And he was thinking, no boatman will be there. How will I reach? Luckily, when he went, he saw. By the time he reached, he saw One boat was on the water already. He got inside. He saw that rowing stick. He started to row. Oh, still it is not coming. Go fast, go fast, go fast. He is rowing. And he became tired. He slept there only in the boat. Next day morning he saw, Ray, what happened? I am here in the boat till I didn't go. Again he is rowing. It is not moving. Then he realized something is wrong. By that time, all the drunkenness went off. He saw the boat is tied up with a tree. He didn't untie the tree, untie the boat from the tree. So whole night he was doing. He was drunk. By that time, he realized the boatman came. He gave him two. What you are? By hitting, he hit the boat. Boat got damaged. And by the time he settled the issue, went back, he saw the body, dead body of his father. He cried, I did not choose the right thing. I did not choose the right thing. God gave me wisdom. God gave me money to buy the medicine for my daddy. But I allowed unwanted elements to enter into my life. And I did not choose the right thing. And I destroyed my life. Whatever you choose, let not what you choose at the cost of that which is passing away. No. Don't throw away the eternal things for things that are passing away. Commit your life for a higher goal and higher purpose for which God will honor you. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.